everyone, and welcome back to my channel. Well, I know that many of you have been waiting for this video already for a very long time. I get all the time comments from you asking when I'm going to continue working on the BTS dolls. Well, the answer is today. Today I'm going to finally continue repainting these BTS dolls from Mattel, released back in September or in August, when they were released. I don't remember it anymore. And today it's finally time to repaint this beautiful RM doll. I was going to actually repaint him first, but I don't know why. I don't even remember why I've changed my mind and I took another doll then back in September, and poor RM had to lay here in my closet waiting for almost half a year to be customized. So today it's finally his day, today it's his time. So I'm going to unbox him, let's see how they've cheated on his outfit again, and then we're going to give him a complete makeover. And while I'm working, of course, please don't forget to support my art here on YouTube with your likes, subscribe to my channel, hit the bell button, well, and I will start working. So, here we find, like always, this ridiculous imitation of a shirt. I'm really curious, guys, how much money do Mattel saved on it? A couple of kilometers of fabric, probably, and hours of their work. Yeah, and then they sell it for a normal price. Sounds nice, yeah. But anyway, let's take it all off, and then I will cut off his hair. This doll's hairstyle looks, of course, quite awkward, but like I've said it already before in my videos, it's pretty impossible to make a short haircut using rerouting hair. It will never look good, and that's why I get rid of all this hair without remorse, and later we will try to recreate really some nicer and more realistic looking hair. I warm up the hat with a hairdryer to make it soft, and after doing this for just 2 minutes, I can remove the hat without damaging the neck, and then I'm going to remove the rest of the hair from the inside of the hat using my tweezers. I really love the face molds of all the dolls from the collection. They're really very detailed with dimples and stuff, but the makeup, it always looks quite pale, and I also hate that you can see the pixels. It really looks like it was made with some cheap printer. I honestly prefer the old way Mattel used for printing the faces on. And these new faces, they're also extremely difficult to remove. You will see, I'm going to rub here for a good 10 minutes for sure with pure acetone before all the paint will be gone. I've even seen people online damaging doll faces trying to remove the stupid paint. But anyway, nothing can stop a person with a passion. Okay, now let's spray the face with a couple of layers of Mr. Super Clear sealant, and then we will create a new face for our guy. First of all, I'm going to sketch the face using watercolor pencils, and then I'm going to add shadows using soft pastels. After this, I'll add highlights and a blush, and I also start drawing the face more detailed. When I'm happy with my final drawing, I add a couple of bright reflections to his eyes using acrylic paint, and then we can start making the hair. I'm going to use this yarn to make his hair today. I know, it doesn't look good at all, but trust me guys, this is the most basic hair color of all possible. I've used it and for poor Cinderella and for Donald Trump, so now it's Aram's time. And it just requires some work of course, but first of all I need to turn this yarn into hair. So first of all I'm cutting this yarn into shorter pieces and I'm tying them around some barbecue sticks. After this I'm going to make this yarn loose. Then I brush it with this brush for cats. And then I make this yarn straight using my flat iron. So when you see, now it starts to look already like real hair. Now I'm going to cut them piece by piece off the stick and I'm going to attach this hair to this doll's hat using tacky glue. I let the glue dry and then I'm making the split. And after this, I can finally cut and style his hair. Thank you. And it looks pretty cool, I think. Now let's take some brown soft pastels and make the roots of the hair a little bit darker. And then I fix the pastels and the complete hairstyle with the hairspray. Well, I really love how Aram looks in black suits. I don't know, he looks extremely stylish in them to me. So I was thinking about making the same costume like his original one, but out of some black fabric. So basically just to copy this costume in black. But then I thought, guys, if Mattel is cheating like this and making these kinds of imitation outfits, then I can cheat as well, I think. So right now, we're going to simply color this costume black, because I really love the way it fits, but I really hate this green pattern. Oh my god, guys, what a bright idea! I have these special markers for drawing on fabric, so let's go, I think it's gonna work. But I also think you can do it with permanent markers as well, such a little life hack for people who also don't like the patterns on their costumes. You know, a couple of fresh permanent markers, and in a couple of hours you have all your BTS dolls dressed in black. Now I let the marker dry for 6 hours, because this is what the packaging says. And then I will iron the outfit, because this is also what the packaging says. Yeah, and then we'll take a look at what we've got. And it looks very good, I think. The pants I took actually from the former Jimin's outfit. He used to wear black pants, so here is our costume. Now let's customize his shoes, and we're almost done. So here is our improved version of Aram. You know, guys, he's staying now in my studio, And I can tell you, he looks super realistic. Every time when I see him, I think, whoa, he looks so alive, it's crazy. And that's why I can probably say that I've probably reached the goal of the makeover, and I've helped this doll to look a little bit better and a little bit more realistic than before. And what do you think, guys? You know, I don't have that many male repaints on my channel, so I would love to hear your feedback. And of course, I want to know what the army think. Is it BTS army approved? Write me your thoughts in the comments under this video. And I'm going to put this doll for sale on eBay. And this time I will be able to make it quite cheaper, because I didn't make the outfit myself and I've saved a couple of days of my work. So if you need a mini RM in your room, go and check it out. The link will be in the description box. So, and that was my doll transformation of the week, guys. I really hope you enjoyed it today. And if so, please don't forget to support my art here on YouTube with your likes. Of course, subscribe to my channel, hit the bell button. And I will see you already very soon, next week, Friday, in my new doll repaint video. Love you guys. Bye.